And welcome back to the Coach's Perspective here on Riverside TV. I'm Jeff Gorham, and I'll tell you what, it has been a couple of great weeks in the city of Riverside as we are now joined by my co-host, my friend, my hero, Gonzalez-san. There he is. Gonzalez, how you doing today, bud?
Jeff, as Charles Barkley once said, or as Chris Webber once told Charles Barkley, I don't believe in role models, but you're mine.
Hey, I love it. I love it. Hey, we've had a couple really good weeks of high school football, couple of big surprises, and let's get right into it. Who was your big surprise of the week this past week?
Well, we're heating up. Let's not talk about surprises yet. It's still early, but all the Riverside teams are in the pool now. They've all dumped their feet in the water. We saw Arlington in week one, and week two, talk about a surprise, how about Pauley taking care of Arlington 40-8. I know Arlington's going to get back on it. They're defending the CIF championship. But how about those boys from Pauley and John Rice? A big win for them over Arlington. You know, then we move over. We love Opie Vaipulu at John W. North High School. They took it on the chin a little bit against Beaumont. We saw that week one. They had the tough loss against Ramona. And Beaumont kind of took them out to the woodshed last week, Jeff.
Yeah, Jeff Steinberg, we know he does a great job. There are reasons you leave jobs when you know the horizon. And I'll tell you what, Beaumont is going to be a very good team. Formidable, maybe a shot to win the whole thing.
They were both in D5 last year, so I thought that would be maybe a preview of a playoff matchup. Hopefully North maybe gets another shot at Beaumont. Hillcrest looked pretty good in week one. They've kind of pushed Pauley around a little bit. Orange Vista, though, 39-10. That was our Thursday game. The Hillcrest that took it on. We see La Sierra this week, Jeff. They lost a tight one on the road in Orange County to Rancho Alamitos. That was a tough loss for them to take. And Notre Dame having a tough first week. Mo Val kind of put it on them, 52-8. They improved this week. They still lost their 0-2. Arrowhead Christian, that was 20-16. They have out in the desert they have this week? Oh, we've done them a couple times. Xavier Prep. They have Xavier Prep this week. So hopefully the Titans can get back on the winning track. The thriller last week, though, was your alma mater heading to Kaiser take on Billy Cardosi and the Cats, 36-35. I know you love kickers. Ramona had a chance to win it, 48 seconds left. The field goal didn't quite get there. Tough loss for Coach Mush and the guys.
Well, you know, it is a tough loss, but I look at it this way. You know, you and I have talked. It could be a loss, though, that could help them if they can win out. It could set them up in a pretty nice division because I'll tell you what, Kaiser has been so darn good for so many years. That could help them come playoff time.
And that was a game that got away from them. Remember, Kaiser took the lead late in the fourth, not late. It was like early in the fourth quarter, but they had to rally back to take the lead. And the defense held up, and Ramona couldn't hit the field goal. And then our game that we had on Riverside TV last week, the operation or the space station of Martin Luther King High's offense is fully operational. They were a little frustrated with the execution against Roosevelt in week one. That wasn't a problem in week zero. That wasn't a problem in week one. 55-7 over Redlands.
And their quarterback goes down in the preseason. How spectacular was King's quarterback in that game just on Friday night?
Yeah, a lot of praise to go around for King on both sides, on offense and defense. My game ball would go to Keon Gant. He stood in there, did everything he needed to do, threw the ball, ran the ball. I think he threw for three, ran for a touchdown. But more importantly, kind of controlled the offense, calmed it down when he needed to.
Yeah, and what a huge improvement we've seen from King. You know, they lost to Roosevelt, who was a CIF semifinalist last game. So they're much improved. And I'll tell you what, Coach McMaines is looking forward, licking his chops into every single game he's getting ready to play.
They're looking forward to Big West Conference play, where they'll be in the lower division, and they hope to maybe make a playoff run.
And let's talk about La Sierra. New look, new coach. Sean Moore comes over. Starting this new program. He's got a new philosophy. They've already have a win under their belt. They lost narrowly in week two. What are your thoughts coming into Friday night when we're going to see the Eagles play Campbell Hall?
Yeah, Campbell Hall's got a couple of legit guys for getting D1 offers. And I'm interested to see what Coach Moore does. He previously was a head coach over at AB Miller, although albeit for only maybe a year or two. So I'm interested. It kind of went under the radar, right? The hire kind of went under the radar. And we know La Sierra, part of the issue has been when Hillcrest came in, they were splitting their student population and they were getting some players. Remember, Jeff Roney actually won the River Valley League his last year there in 2013 or 2014. They actually won the River Valley League. They actually beat Nor Vista that year. Remember, that was when kind of Ken Backdorf controlled the realm a little bit. So it'd be nice to see La Sierra at the very least be competitive. You know, Gary Hedlund had that one year where they did some nice things but couldn't quite get into the playoffs. And there was the one year where they had the five-way tie back in the day, back in 2017 it was. But, you know, it's always better when La Sierra can compete and be good. And hopefully Coach Moore can bring that to them. I'm excited to see them. You know, Campbell Hall is no joke. They're 2-0. They've legitimate. Now, they're a little bit lean because they have a lot of guys playing both ways. So maybe he can get the better of them coming on the road from L.A. to Riverside. But should be an exciting matchup on Friday for La Sierra against Campbell Hall.
Well, you know, from what I've heard from all the coaches, there is a buy-in at La Sierra. I think last year they had, you know, roughly like 50 kids in the program, and I think they're well over 100 this year. So Coach Moore, we're going to have him later on in the show. Those are some big numbers, and I'm sure when you have big numbers, you're going to only do one thing, and that's improve, improve, improve.
We found that with COVID kind of easing up now, the participation numbers are going up. I think every coach you and I have talked to, Jeff, has said they're happier with their participation numbers. Last year, we had a lot of teams that could not field freshman teams. That hasn't been the case so much this year. Be interested to see what Coach Moore talks to you about later today.
And before we get going, and we will have that game Friday night, you and I will be on the call. Nick Rice will be on the sidelines as La Sierra will play Campbell Hall. But there's a big one Saturday afternoon at Ramona High School as the state runner-up RCC Tigers are starting their season against Mount San Jacinto.
I'd be interested to see what Coach Moore, what Coach Kraft has in store over there. We mentioned 2019, they won the state and the national championship, did not compete in 2020 because of COVID. And then although a couple of early losses last year, Jeff, they were able to make the state final, just fell short of the state final last year. So you know the core is back for RCC, and they always figure out what to do on offense. And when their defense is good, James Cook, their defense coordinator, they're just a tough team to beat. I'm excited. New venue for them as well, playing their home games this year at Ramona High School while Wheelock undergoes some renovation.
Well, I'm really looking forward to seeing the Retzloff brothers in action. Remember, the Retzloffs, one's a receiver, one's a quarterback, a Division I transfer. I'm looking forward to watching them play. We always know Coach Kraft does magical things with his quarterbacks.
Yeah, they're always fun to watch. I mean, they always light the scoreboard up. But generally, when they succeed, it's how well their defense plays. And Mount San Jacinto is no joke. They can put some points on the board as well. I think they averaged close to 500 yards a game last year, so it'll be a battle between those two local squads.
Well, Gazal, you and I will be on the call for both Friday and the Saturday matinee as we head on for week two. Week two, considering it was week zero, third week of the season, and you and I will have the call. As always, it's great to see you. Look forward to seeing you Friday night, my friend.
Always good to talk to you, Jeff. See you Friday.
Well, he's Gazal Hassan. I'm Jeff Gorham. We'll be right back on the Coach's Perspective with the head coach from La Sierra, Coach Moore. We'll be right back on Riverside TV. And we are back here on the Coach's Perspective as we are now joined by the new head coach of La Sierra High School, Sean Moore. Coach Moore, how are you doing today, my friend?
Doing good. Excited. We got Campbell Hall this week. You know, let's figure out what we do here.
Well, Coach, you're brand new to the Eagles this year. They've had a couple coaches in the last few years. Great to see somebody new. Tell us a little bit about your background, where you came from, Coach, and introduce yourself to the city of Riverside.
Definitely. Big thing is I came from Miller, Excelsior. I'm a Brewitt kid. You know, I was coached by Dick Brewitt. That is probably my favorite coach of all time, and I've had a lot of them. So definitely, I'm a no-nonsense coach, very disciplined. Our team's going to be disciplined. That is a big thing of mine. And, you know, as knowing Dick Brewitt, that's just what we were back then as well. I'm excited to be here. I think there's a lot of wins here. We just got to put it together.
Well, speaking of that Brewitt coaching tree, I mean, it's extensive. It seems like every coach I talk to has some affiliation to Coach Brewitt. Do you guys still talk a little bit and you get his advice ever?
I have in the past. We haven't talked in a while. I'll tweet him on Twitter real quick and, things of that nature. But he is always, he's always been, hey, you need me? Reach out to me. And so Brewick is just, he's an amazing coach. You know, he was a no-nonsense coach. And anybody who was coached by him, I think, you know, we all have the same thing to say about him.
Well, I consider him a friend. I never played or coached with him. He's yelled at me a couple times, so maybe I feel like I'm part of the crew, to say the least. But let's talk about this La Sierra team. You got the job here a little late, and what have been some of the positive points you've got from your young Eagles team this year?
I'll be honest with you, they want to win. They want to win, and I know that sounds cliche, but they really want to win. They've been putting in a lot of hard work. You know, as our little mantra is, we set the trend. You know, we want to get to winning ways at La Sierra. That's the big thing. And I think we took a huge leap winning 32-18 in that first game against Whittier Christian. And, you know, you always got to look at losses. There's two ways to look at it. With the last game, 7-10, where, you know, and as I put it on the board for them last week, or on Saturday, as I told them, last year, 34-0, the second game, 7-10, the second game this year. And I think that was an improvement, but obviously we want the wins. We got some skill, and I think we just got to put them in the right place and be successful.
Well, I know the Alvord District, and I know everybody's excited for that first win. Like I said, a tough loss the second game, but you have a very, very formidable opponent this week, Campbell Hall, normally known as a basketball school, but they've kind of become a football school as of late.
Yes, Campbell Hall is a good opponent. I've faced them before, about 3-4 years ago, and, you know, I think I have more athletes here, and I truly do believe. I mean, we have 102 kids in the program right now, all three levels. And I think, you know, where they're sitting at, you know, just 29, 30. So I think that's a big in our favor. You know, we just got to come out and execute. And that's our biggest thing.
And if when somebody comes out and they watch the game Friday night, what kind of offense are they going to see from the Eagles?
We're a spread-based offense. We want to be high-powered. You know, I'm hearing great things about Ramona and some of those other teams out there, but, you know, we want to be in that mix too. You know, like I said, the first game, you know, we were down 18-8, and then we kind of exploded in the second half and 24 unanswered points. You know, we watched film Saturday morning, and there were so many points left on the field, and you best believe we're going to fix that. So I think we can be an explosion this week.
Yeah, talking to the other coaches around the league, you know, I'm friends with Ken Battendorf, Ken Mashinsky, all those guys, and they all told me the same thing. You have a bright young quarterback who's able to throw the football.
Yes, Ty Owens. You know, it's one of those things where he's coming over you know, he's got a bright future, about 6'2 and a half, 6'3". He can sling it. You know, we also have TJ Reyes. I mean, he's probably all league again. If we do it right, you know, we got Jonathan Watson. That's one of our big boys, and he does not play around. You know, David Butner, I mean, he's 6'4", 305, and he plays end. Okay, so we got some pieces.
Now, defensively, what do you guys like to run? And maybe name some of those guys that are going to help the Eagles come Friday night.
We have a really good linebacker. We just moved him to linebacker. He was playing line last year. And it's Matthew Cardenas. I mean, this kid has woke up, I'm excited about it. We have Gio, our left corner. This kid is a bunch of energy. He's ready to go. We got a pick the first week, excited about it. He did some good things last week, too. TJ Reyes, he plays safety for us. And then we got a couple of new kids that we think we're going to be able to put out there this week. Derek Rocha, you know, we have Emmanuel Quintero as well. We got some nice group of defense. I mean, like I said, 7-10. Our defense held, but you know how it is when you're on the field as much as you are. Sometimes things happen.
Now, some of the goals that you guys have set yourself, what are some of the team goals you guys have?
You know, the biggest thing, like I said, we set the trend is our motto, and our biggest thing is making the playoffs. I think that's a huge thing, but, you know, we have goals every week. So, you know, we have yard goals every week. We have rushing goals every week. You know, we want to set the tempo every week. We go 1-0 every week. We don't want to jump ahead too much because I think that's where you lose. So Every week we have goals, and that's very important to us.
Well, Coach, what are some of the things? I mean, you've got, there has to be some excitement around campus. You won your first game. Have you noticed it, the palpable excitement around campus since you've been there?
I'll tell you this. You know, I was told that that was the most people at a home game in a long time. We were almost packed. So I think that there is a lot of excitement. You know, and the kids are buying in. I mean, at the end of the day, when you have film Saturday morning and everyone shows up, that's saying the program's going somewhere. You know, and like I said, we're no nonsense coaching staff. So, you know, that's very exciting to see. Yet we came off a tough loss, but as I told him, you know, it'd be different if it was 45-0 and we lost. That team was just better than us. 7-10, we just made mistakes that shot us in the foot. So I think the school's really excited, and we're going to keep playing week by week.
Well, Coach, we are very, very excited to see you guys, the new look Eagles, come Friday night when you guys battle Campbell Hall. Ghazal Hassan, myself, and Nick Rice will be on the sidelines, and we will be there to support the Eagles.
I appreciate it. I look forward to it. Look forward to it, and it's going to be exciting. You know, let's go Riverside.
He's Sean Moore, the head coach of La Sierra High School. We'll be right back on The Coach's Perspective here on Riverside TV. And we are back to The Coach's Perspective here on Riverside TV. And as always, it's my favorite part of the show with my best friend in the entire world, Mr. Pep Fernandez. There he is. How you doing today, Pep?
Big Jeff, what is cracking, man? How are you?
I'll tell you what, man. I am exhausted from the football so far. We are only in week three, week two, zero week. I don't care what it is, but I'll tell you what, we've had some great football in the past couple weeks. What are you thinking about all this so far?
We've had some great games, man. And when you look at the city of Riverside, I think we've got a couple teams that could win, you know, league championships, obviously playing in different leagues. We've got the River Valley League. We've got teams in the Raincross Conference. So I think it's going to be good, and we had one of the best games of the season this past Friday with Ramona and Kaiser.
Oh, I'll tell you what, my Rams went to defeat by one. They beat my friend Billy Cardosi. I was crushed. I was heartbroken. But I'll tell you what, we saw some great things coming from that Ramona team, and I'll be honest with you, I think they run the table after that game, and I think they're going to go on to win some big, big games and possibly a championship. But let's talk a little bit about why you're here today, Pep, and that is talk about the great Nate Johnson. You and I have had a chance to watch this young man who's the quarterback at Ramona for a few years. And I'll tell you what, he is something special, isn't he?
Yeah, he is. You know, a lot of teams in our area, they've got good ground games, right? They get good running backs, and that's the hallmark of a great team. But you need a great quarterback as well. That's what separates the good teams from the great teams. And Ramona is a great team because they have a great quarterback in Nate Johnson. And listen, Bo Bruins is one of the best running backs in the entire Inland Empire, no doubt. But his job is easier when you have a great quarterback like Nate Johnson that's going to keep that opposing defense on their toes, because you never know when he's going to pop off a big throw. I saw it firsthand against Kaiser. We caught on, you know, on film a couple touchdowns to Jacob Valenzuela, Jordan Daniels. He's got some great receivers, but Nate Johnson, no doubt, one of the top QBs in our area.
You know what's special about this? And I think some people will look at it, maybe they'll go, oh, you know, the coach. His coach is his father. And, I mean, what better story than being a senior? You have one of the best teams in the city. You basically have an extra coach on the field with Nate Johnson, don't you?
Yeah, Jeff, listen, I know you're a basketball guy, so you get this. You know, the point guard is an extension of the head coach, right? Calling plays and directing guys when you're out on the field. The quarterback is that guy. He's the point guard. He's running the guys on the offense. He's calling the plays. If a guy looks out of place, he's pointing him back into place, all those sorts of things. So your quarterback not only has to be athletically gifted, but, Jeff, you know this, Nathan is very, very smart, beyond straight-A smart.
Yeah, he's got a 4.5 grade point average. He played three sports last year. I think he's going to try to play four sports this year. He's just an all-around guy who loves to be in high school, loves to be a part of it. And you got to really respect a kid like that, especially with your father who's the head coach. He's got a lot riding on his shoulders.
And here's the best part, Jeff. We probably buried the lead on this. Great football player, outstanding student, but an awesome person, man. So polite. So humble, and that's the kind of kid you want leading your football team.
And you know what? We have a special guest that I think we need to bring
in.
I think we need to say this. She is the brains of the Mashinsky family. As we're now joined by Jennifer Mashinsky, head coach of Ramona High School and the mom of Nate Johnson. Welcome to the show, Jennifer Mashinsky. Wow.
I am so flattered. Jeff, Pep, wow, that intro is unbelievable. I can't believe all those wonderful things you said about my son. I am truly, truly appreciative of that. So yes, we love him and we think he's amazing, but to hear those words out of your mouth, I can't even tell you how happy that makes us. But he has to work for it, as you know. I mean, being the quarterback of and the son of the head coach, it's not an easy task. It's really fun around here sometimes, I can tell you, as the mom and the wife.
So my big question to you is, what's it like after a Friday night, win or lose?
It's a good question. Ken is very controlled, and if it's a win, it's great. He's super happy, obviously, but he's already on to the next team. He's downloading film, sending it to the next coach, thinking about strategy, thinking about what they're going to do. He's never satisfied. He has super high expectations. He's looking at what happened in the game, what tweaks they need to make, what adjustments. That's a lot to go through. So it's like you can celebrate for a short amount of time. I think the booster clubs, which, by the way, I'd like to shout out to all the amazing people at the booster club at Ramona High School. We celebrate a lot longer than Coach Ken Mashinsky. And then after a loss, there's a lot of analysis and there's a lot of conversation. I mean, after the Kaiser lost by 1 point, at one point, I have to admit, I walked and I said, we should probably save this for the field. And they both looked at me like, no, we want to keep talking about it. So I said, okay, I'm out.
Now, also, on the flip side, Nate and Dad, when they have disagreements, does it spill over at home? Like, do they fight at home after practice, or is Nate a pretty level-headed guy? Because we know Ken can be a little wild. Is Nate the more level-headed of the two?
That's such a nice way to say it. I've known Ken Mashinsky since eighth grade.
I heard.
And Ken's intensity as a player, as a coach, from the time we were, you know, 15 or 19 to now, I mean, he's always had such a passion and love for sports, for football especially, and for education. So that's why I think, and I do have to say that he's an amazing teacher outside of the field. But Nathan is, I would say, opposite of Ken and I. Ken and I are very similar. So Nathan is very patient, and he observes, and he just kind of takes a step back, which I think helps when they have those conversations. But there have been moments where they're kind of going back and forth and they see things differently. And I remember there was one point, I think it was summer going into junior year, where I had to say, all right, we need to think about this as a family. If it's really not great, like it needs to be, you need to be Coach Mush and quarterback on the field. In the house, your dad and your son. And it's pretty much done. It's been that way ever since. So it's been pretty good. But it is hard for me at times. I do feel like in the middle because I see both sides.
Well, Jen, I'm just curious. Actually, this is a two-part question. So one is, were you a football fan before you got into all this? And second, being the coach's wife and the quarterback's mom, how hard is it to sit there and watch the game, especially if it's a really close game like that Kaiser game this last week? How difficult? I mean, are you pacing or is it you get antsy? What's that like?
So part one, I loved watching football. I didn't have older brothers. I didn't have any cousins who played it. So it really wasn't in my sphere. Nathan was going to be a baseball player. That was my brain. And when he wanted to play, I said, okay, flag football's fine. And then he wanted to play tackle. And I would say no year after year after year. And Ken never pressured, ever. It was all my choice. I was like every other mom out there who's worried about their child getting banged around. And I'll never forget. Nathan comes to me going into seventh grade and he says, Mom, I hope I don't embarrass him. Mom, football is life and life has challenges. Please let me play tackle football. Football will prepare me for life's challenges. And I saw this look on his face and I was like, I can't deny it. So then I said, okay, fine, but you better listen to those coaches. And if I see you doing anything wrong, I'm going to pull you off that field. And he's like, okay.
That's a very mature response from a seventh grade kid.
He wanted to play so bad. And then he wanted to be a quarterback. And Ken and I were kind of steering him away from that position. Not because we didn't think he was capable, but Ken knows firsthand as a quarterback himself and how hard he is and how high his expectations are, how that dynamic would be on Nathan. And Nathan's risen to the challenge. And one thing about Ken is there is no daddy ball at Ramona High School with Ken Myshinsky, and Nathan had to fight for that position. And of course, we all thought, oh God, people are going to think perception, like, oh yeah, of course he's going to play. He's the head coach's son, but Nathan fought for that, and I am so proud of him.
Wait, hold on, Jen. I got to circle back, though. What were you doing during the Kaiser game, or pick any close game that Ramon has had? A CIF championship game a couple seasons ago. Like, what do you do during the game? Are you freaking out?
I'm either pacing down on the field. You might see me going back and forth. You might see me with Laura Shiner, head softball coach. We're like that. The Kaiser game, I was just staring at him. I had to realize I have no control over this. All I can do is cheer for him and pray he's okay and think about his health and just enjoy him. It's his senior year. I just have to enjoy him because I just love watching him play. And I love watching Ken give him signals. It's unbelievable to see my husband give a signal to my son and my son execute. And then there's like a touchdown. I can't, it's surreal. It's absolutely surreal. I'm very lucky.
Now, as parents, Pep and I are both parents, and, you know, it's always nice to gloat about your children. Well, we're going to give you that opportunity. We really want to know, you know, in a nutshell, I mean, just give us the bio of what you think, how wonderful your son is, because you have the floor, and feel free to gloat for your son all you like.
Oh, my gosh. Wow. Okay. Well, I think our family's humble, and we sort of taught Nathan to be that way, so this is kind of uncomfortable, but I will say Nathan, outside of any sports, he is just the kindest person I have ever known. He's sweet, he is thoughtful, patient, and he's funny, and he cares a lot about other people, and I'm just so darn proud of him. I guess I've always underestimated him. I've always known he could do what he wants to do, but as a mom, you still are scared of your kids being in certain situations. And, you know, he does what he says he's gonna do. It's admirable. And the team's amazing, the admin's amazing, the booster club, we're so lucky at Ramona. I've never seen anything like it. So it's truly a family setting.
Hey,
so we're very lucky.
I know what it's like. I went to Ramona. Go Rams!
Thank you very much, representing the Rams.
Well, Jennifer, thank you for your time, and we really want to thank you. I know Pep was saying the same thing. We really appreciate that you have such a great young man as a son. He's a great quarterback. He's a great leader, and you are a great family, and we really applaud you and support you. You've done a great job. She's Jennifer Myshinsky, the mom and wife of Ramona High School, wouldn't you say, Pep?
Yeah, she's like the first lady of Ram High, right?
She is. Well, Jennifer, we appreciate everything you do for us here at Riverside TV, and good luck the rest of the season. We'll be following the Rams down the line.
I thank you for all the coverage you do. I love how much you love high school and college sports and how well you cover the area. You two as sportscasters are amazing. Thank you, and Gasol, thank you for all you do.
Look at that, Pep. We got some love. Well, this will do it for the end of this episode of The Coach's Perspective. For Pep Fernandez, Jennifer Myshinsky, Jeff Gorham, thank you again. We'll see you next week on the Riverside TV Coach's Perspective.